Arlene Israel, the death toll in the Philippines is climbing while the pace of the aid effort is picking up. The government now says Typhoon Haiyan killed more than 3,600 people, and some officials are still projecting that will top 10,000 once the missing are declared dead and remote areas are accounted. Heather Sells has the latest.
1 week after Typhoon Haiyan devastated the Philippines, many survivors are still desperate and waiting for basic supplies.
We have no food, no water, no lights, no fuel.
But across the region, observers agree that the pace of aid is finally picking up. Typhoon Haiyan first made landfall in the town of Guian. It's been cut off since the storm, but now the Philippines Air Force is dropping supplies. Gasoline is available on a limited basis, and communication with the outside world is beginning. These people lined up to use a free telephone to call distant family.
We are calling our family that from other country because we are out there, they are not aware what's happening to us here in our place.
In Manila, the president is defending the government's relief efforts. He visited a repackaging center for relief goods and urged Filipinos to volunteer. We need to lift up our countrymen so they will have the capability to take care of themselves, he said. In Tacloban, many are still surviving in a chaotic environment. Some have found shelter in this Astrodome, but it's a situation filled with grime and filth. The Interior Secretary of the Philippines acknowledged the challenge.
In a situation like this, nothing is fast enough. The need is massive. The need is immediate.
CBN Disaster Relief is on the ground in some of the hardest hit areas, working with the military to distribute relief goods, including water purification devices to disinfect thousands of gallons each day, along with medicine, food, blankets, and more. It's a sign of hope, as are these cleanup efforts in a country where 500,000 people still need a home and lots of help. Heather Sells, CBN.